So intimate partner violence is all about power and control. And if we want to understand why somebody would be abusive, it's important to know that we still need to do a lot more research about men who are abusive to their intimate partner to their intimate partners. But one thing that we know is that a lot of men who are abusive, not all, but a lot, tend to actually have really low self-esteem, and they want to try to be in control of everything in their lives, including their intimate partners. And what we know from research is also that those men who have low self-esteem also are actually extremely emotionally dependent on their partners. And the first time that I learned this, I was confused because I thought, if somebody is so emotionally dependent on his partner, why would he be harming her? Because then she would want to leave him. But it makes sense if we think about these abusive, controlling men. They're essentially, they want to feel like they're in control of everything in their lives, including their partners. And they're very afraid of their partners leaving them because they depend on them so much. So often they'll end up playing mind games with them psychologically, right? Because they, in their minds, they're reasoning that if they convince their wife, for example, that she's fat and ugly, then she's not going to want to leave them because she's going to be convinced she's fat and ugly and she can't find anyone else. So that's one example of why a batterer might employ some of that psychological abuse. But really what the psychological abuse does, and why it's so important to understand that type of violence, is the psychological abuse sets up a very different reality for the victimized partner. So from an outsider's perspective, we would look into an abusive relationship and say, wow, he comes home every night and he finds some type of fault with the dinner she's prepared for him, and then he yells at her and tells her how stupid she is, and then if he's in a particularly bad mood, he slams her against the kitchen cabinets, right? Or he locks her in the bedroom. But from the victimized person's perspective, if she has been enduring months and months and years of verbal abuse, abuse and emotional abuse, the violence seems to just be the logical next step. And so what a lot of batterers will do is actually start playing mind games with their partners so that the partner's understandings and perceptions of reality become really warped. So for example, a man who is abusive to his girlfriend might tell her that he wants her to prepare spaghetti and meatballs for dinner that night. So she spends time in the kitchen preparing the spaghetti and meatballs, and she already knows what happens if he doesn't like the dinner set up just the right way. So she's very, very careful about the preparation. She sets the table. He comes home from work, and he says, "Why in the hell did you make spaghetti and meatballs? I told you I wanted chicken and potatoes." And he insists to her that he wanted chicken and potatoes, and then he proceeds to berate her and tell her that she's so stupid and she's forgetful and she can't even remember a simple little thing like what he wants for dinner. And she doesn't have anyone to verify that earlier conversation with. So she begins to think, wow, maybe he's right. He's insisting that he said he wanted chicken and potatoes. And by this point, he's really successfully isolated her from all of her family and her friends. So she knows she'll get in trouble if she picks up the phone to call her mom to talk about this problem. So she's essentially being trapped inside her home, inside her own head. And she's starting to think, maybe he's right. Maybe I am stupid. Maybe I am ignorant. Maybe I am forgetful. And so that is just one simple example of why it's so important to understand that psychological control and the mind games.